Welcome to the America East Soccer Championship. It's a beautiful day here in Baltimore, and today the UMBC Retrievers and New Hampshire Wildcats will decide the 2010 America East Soccer Championship.
Take a look at the first half highlights. Andrew, a couple of good chances for both sides.
Yeah, you saw that early on, Levy going near side. Great job by O'Donnell. And then you see here this shot by Chris Williams. Real quick shot from outside, almost caught O'Donnell out of position. Good recovery there. And then you see UNH's two chances. Head ball by Palumbo into the box with a great save by Luisa now. And then another Palumbo save, you'll see, or another Palumbo shot here. You see Deke create the shot. Blistering shot to the upper 90 on the left-hand side and just a foot off the post there. Two good opportunities for both
teams.
Ladies
and gentlemen, we are going to shootouts to decide the America East Soccer Championship in 2010. Right, Luisa now in net. Brad Hilton will preside first off here. And here we go. Hilton drives it into the net, so New Hampshire gets on first as Hilton goes to the left side and beats Luising now to make it 1-0. Right, O'Donnell in the net. Wapu presides. And Levy approaches and scores.
Striker of the year, goaltender of the year, and Levy finally gets one in. Levy, great job there.
Let's see if Luisa now can stop this one. And here we go. Corsello contemplating. Shot and a save! Save by Luisa now as he picked the right angle, picked the right side, and made the save. If McNabb scores, UMBC can win it with their fifth shot. If McNabb cannot score, Luisa now save, wins the game for UMBC.
And the crowd is on its feet. The noise here, very loud. A lot of pressure on McNabb, the sophomore. Can he extend this game?
Approaches. Shot. Score! Oh, my. What a clutch shot that was from McNabb. And he ties things up at 4. All right. It's all on John Paul Rawaksa now. The senior from Media PA. Rawaksa can win it for the Retrievers against the all-conference keeper, Colin O'Donnell. He approaches. Rawaksa shoots. Score! Score! UMBC wins!
Coach Pete Karinji gets his first America East Championship. The Retrievers, their first America East Championship. And the Retrievers are going to the College Cup as the America East Champions for 2010.
I'm with UMBC head coach Pete Karinji. Coach, congratulations on the victory today. You kind of knew it was going to be like this. They were a great defensive team. It was a struggle all the way. You finally got them in the penalty kick session.
Yeah, we knew that. That's all we stressed all day before the game was to try to really put the pressure on them because they like to get the game into overtime and take their opportunities. A very opportunistic team, and they're a great defensive team. But we really wanted to press the issue the whole game. And, we've been practicing penalty kicks because we knew it could come down to this with that team.
I thought you guys showed great patience in not getting out of your game, not trying to press things and then having to give up a counterattack goal. You guys did what you needed to do to get where you needed to get to.
Well, I think that's what we learned from last year. I mean, last year we actually lost to them here, and we kept pressuring and really trying to score, and we got lost our shape a little bit, and they scored a goal late in the game, and we knew that's how they beat Boston. So we were going to be composed and keep our shape, and if we score goals, we were going to score. If not, we'll take it to penalty kicks.
You really get an appreciation. We talked about it during the broadcast, the Sun Field today for both teams. Was go through the strategy in the overtime sessions and picking which side you wanted, and then getting to where you needed to get to.
Well, we wanted to go and try to shoot with the sun in the eyes of the goalkeeper, and obviously we won the toss, and we really tried to put pressure on, and you see Bulls hit some great shots, and to their credit, their goalkeeper, I mean, he could be professional, and we had our chances, and then you see when they had the sun, they just started driving balls in, and our defenders were really struggling with heading the ball and trying to clear it out.
Now, I want to get back. You talked about last year. This championship, you aren't the seed sown last year. You were such a young team last year, but you guys came together. You got to this point last year, and you didn't finish, but this year you guys did finish.
Yeah, this was a year at coming. I mean, last year we were a very young team, and we surprised a lot of people. We were nationally ranked, and then we struggled a little bit into the conference, and we made a great run at the end. And just like they did, we were fifth seed, and that's very difficult to come out of a fifth seed and play 3 games all on the road. But we learned a lot last year, and we learned that you have to really have a great October, and we've done that. We realize how important it is to play a home game in this conference because it's a lot of travel and it's a lot of games. And I give them guys a lot of credit, New Hampshire, because they played hard and it came down to one penalty kick. So, you got to say a lot for them because as a fifth seed, we knew how hard it was last year.
The automatic bid now, any thoughts on pairings or where you guys maybe stand in the tournament?
No, I mean, we're excited about being in it, but we think we're going to do well. I mean, I know the last time we went in the tournament, we had a great team in 99, and we played the number one team in the country and had them on the ropes. But this is a very confident group and a very veteran group, and we're just looking forward to see who we play, and I think we'll do all right.
I was talking about on the broadcast, you know, Julianna Salenza and Billy Nelson, they still talk about that game and how they let Duke off the hook that day.
Yeah, Julianna Salenza, P.J. Wakefield, Billy Nelson, those guys were all great players and had great professional careers. And that's what I told these guys before the game. This is going to be a team, I think, when we look back years from now, Levy will be an MLS player, Levy Wapu, Andrew Bulls. We have a couple players who could play professionally, and I think we'll be talking about this team like we did at 99.
Coach, congratulations on the win.
Thank you.
Coach Pete Kerenji here, and with most outstanding player of the America East Championship Tournament, Levy Wapu. First of all, Levy, congratulations on the win. You guys really fought hard out there and really let the game come to you and finally got it done in penalty kicks.
Oh, yeah, thank you. Thank you. We worked so hard for this as a team. You know, it feels really good to win the championship in front of our home crowd.
Little different scenario. I mean, Stony Brook game, you took control in the semifinals, scored 2 goals in the first half. Really a real tough defensive day. I know you were a little bit frustrated out there today. You couldn't get through 4 or 5 guys, but you guys had the patience. You waited your time. You played good defense and then took care of business.
You know, we knew that coming into this game, our new NH was going to be a really good defensive team. You know, we had to stay patient and basically look for that goal. And unfortunately, that goal never came. But, you know, we got it done in PKs. Great job by Dan, the keeper. He made that great save on the PK.
Talk about the PKs and kind of what's going through your mind as you come up. You know, you really set the tone with that first shot. What are you looking at and what are you trying to do? Just get the ball on goal?
Oh yes. I mean, it's a PK shootout. I mean, you have to score. I mean, basically to keep your team in. And as a captain, I was able to do that, and that gave my team some confidence. And we're gonna take that and go to the next game and wait on Monday to see who we play in the NCAA.
Now, you got to credit Dan Luis to now the big save that gave you guys a chance to win it 5-4. Talk about that first, and then John Paul Warwaksa stepping up and really icing the game for you guys.
Yes, that was a great save by Dan. Dan is a great keeper. And then the last year was JP, you know, who's also a leader of this team. You know, he stepped up big time and nailed that PK, and that was a great feeling.
Outstanding. Levy, congratulations. Good luck in the College Cup.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
You got it. Most outstanding player, Levy Wapu, with us. And that's going to do it here. UMBC wins it today. They're the 2010 America East champions in soccer.